Hi there, it's me, the Swedish guitar again, and today I want to prove that I'm not afraid of my more feminine side. So today I'll be reviewing a guitar that's targeted for girls, actually. It's this one. It's Daisy Rock, a company that even in their name says they're guitars for girls. And this is their Debutante Rock Candy Princess model. I suppose Debutante means beginners, so yeah, that's what this is aiming for. And I should point out before I even do the review that this comes as a package. You get not only this guitar, you get a 10-watt amp, you get a tuner, you get a DVD, you get, some picks and a strap, a gig bag. Yeah, basically a starter's pack. But I'm only reviewing the guitar, so... But one can keep that in mind, because the price is... Yeah, it's really low, actually, if you consider all those parts, all those things you get in the package. Okay, so let's go through the materials and hardware. We have... Grover replicas here as tuners, mini Grovers, and they are really good. I like these tuners, so good start there. This is not something we're used to hearing when I'm reviewing guitars. This is actually a good one when it comes to tuners. We have a maple neck, a rosewood fingerboard. So that's pretty basic stuff. That's what you have on almost all my guitars that I've reviewed. Yeah. And then we had a body that's made of selected wood. Or I think they say something like that on their specs. And since this is targeted for girls, and I'll get back to that later in about the dimensions of it, I should think that they would make it light, actually, because they have made it smaller, so why aren't they making it lighter? Because the wood they have selected is rather heavy. It's a rather heavy guitar, actually, for its size. So if they really had done their work, then it would be a lighter body. What materials we have in the body? Well, I don't have a clue. Supposedly it's wood, at least. yeah, what else? We have a wraparound bridge that's pre-intonated. This one-piece thing. Yeah, it's basically like the one that PRS is using on their SC and even their American models. Well, it has its pros and cons. If you use any standard tunings, then it won't be a problem. But if you change tunings, then this might be a problem. Because this is a preset to standard tuning. As we will also notice, that sometimes you need to raise just one string or maybe two. As is the case with this guitar. And you can't do that. You have to raise and lower them all. So that is a drawback. But this is cutting the costs, I suppose. There's nothing else to it. And this, well, they made it really cheap. And yeah. That's one pickup, one volume. That's it. Rock and roll. materials and hardware, I give it an 8. It has all the features that an electric guitar should have, and yeah, if you're cutting the prices, well, this is probably what you end up with, because they kept it working, they didn't remove anything, and I like to especially mention the tuners that they kept, actually. Okay, let's talk about build quality and durability. Well, we can start at the neck. Or we can start at the tuners. The tuners were good, but they are made for a thicker neck or headstock. You can really see it, and that looks kind of strange. They are pointing out really far. That's not really a problem. It just looks strange. Other than that, the neck, we have some extra wood here, just behind the nut. And that's where this, since we have an angle of the headstock to improve sustain, this is prone to break, and when it breaks here. So they've added wood here, and this you see on quite a few guitars these days. Gibson still doesn't do it, I think, for some reason. So this is a really good thing that they thought of it, and that they even bothered on this kind of cheap and beginner's guitar. We have a very big black plastic nut. Looks like a piece of Swedish licorice, and it's really too big. I don't know why they made it like that. Okay, we have medium jumbo frets, or even jumbo frets. They're actually rather thick and fat. The fretwork is my biggest complaint about this guitar. It hasn't been done properly. On most places it's working, but there are places, for instance, the G string of the fifth fret. You can't really hear the note, it buzzes out. Also, on the top two strings above the 20th fret, it buzzes. And it has to do with how they handle the frets. So here we can note that it's a cheap guitar. Other than that, the neck is... wood-wise, it's well-made, actually. It's really well-made. Okay, we have a four-bolt recessed joint. Nice thing. The neck joins pretty good to the body. It's not really mega tight, but it's decent. These are recessed. The control cavity isn't, for strange reasons. That's not a common thing in any guitars I've ever had. That looks kind of cheap. Then we have this finish. And there aren't really any, probably you won't see it even in my video, there aren't any pictures that do this justice. It's really, I like it a lot. It's like some really nice nail polish. They call it Atomic Pink. But on the other hand, this is one of the worst paint jobs I've ever seen. It's very uneven. And it's not a flat surface at all, I'm afraid. But it weighs up with the good look of it. You have a back contour, actually, and that's a good thing. That's not a common thing in these single cut designs, so it makes it easier to play. So build quality, durability, I give it a 6. Since mostly the fret job and the paint job, but durability-wise, they really made it good. I think the tuners are good, the bridge is good, so yeah. Other than that, it will last. And if you spend the money on refretting it, it would probably be really amazing, actually.